Hi everyone, it's Katie and this is my sixth video log entry, I think, about keeping an octopus. Just in case you missed the story, basically I've never kept even a goldfish before, and an octopus is not fresh water, it has to be kept in saltwater aquariums, so jumping straight in the deep end. I bought a used aquarium last week and at 2 a.m. in the morning, very tired, carrying it up my stairs, I cracked the back pane of glass. Totally my fault. So at the moment, we have the animals that came with the aquarium in these two buckets behind me, and trying to keep them alive. Should get a replacement tank this weekend. It's been a week and a half since I blogged last, so I've learned quite a lot. Let's start with the lights. Basically, I didn't know what the lights were for, but now I have been told that there's a blue one, which isn't on at the moment, and that's just for actually making the corals look nice when they're in a tank, and not really needed right now unless I want to take a peek. And this nice strobing light here, which is not strobing in real life, is a 150 watt light, which I've now set on timer to come on 8 hours a day between 2 p.m. and 10 p.m. for these two buckets, and an octopus will, I think, not need as much light as that. So the lights have been set up on this makeshift pole with wire cable, and they're running now on a timer. The fish was just referring to my notes down here. There's a single clamfish and he needed oxygen, so I ran out on Monday a week ago and picked up this air pump, which I originally had on the floor, but it's now above the height of the bucket, and that goes in here and is connected to, I'll just turn the pump off so you can see if I can find the right one. That is connected to an airstone down here. Let me see if I can find it. Here. Which, as you can see, produces bubbles when you put it in the water. So that's down at the bottom, wedged under a piece of rock, making sure that the fish has got oxygen and that the CO2 is coming out of the water. The next problem was filtration. So you've got a filter sock here, which is a mechanical filter, and inside there is carbon. Now originally this was just lying against the side and the water was going through it passively, but now I've tied it to some string and it's hanging above the water, and then I used my siphon here. Is pulling water out of the bucket and back into here, and the carbon was loose, but now I put it in a stocking and tied it up, which is the chemical filter, and the water is being pushed through there, so the filtration should be a lot better. Now the fish is here, he's a clamfish, please don't call him Nemo, he wasn't eating shrimp or flake food, but I put him on a diet for a couple of days. I'm just feeding him once every couple of days now, just a little bit of this flake food because the shrimp makes too much ammonia, and he is now eating it, so that's good. Hopefully he's not hungry, he's certainly not overfed. And what was the next thing? There's this build-up of orange stuff on the side of both buckets. It's a lot worse in this bucket. I didn't know what it was. It comes off very easily with your hand, and I'm guessing it's just bits of rock and stuff because it doesn't look like algae to me, so I haven't worried about it too much. The main problem this week, we've got two buckets here, one with live rock in, one with the fish. and the ammonia level was too high, and changing the water didn't help. And the reason for that partly is because as soon as I mixed fresh salt water, it already had ammonia in. The RO purified water had zero ammonia. Put the salt in, mix it, and then it was 1.5 parts per million or milligrams per liter. So I don't know why it's done that, but in any case, the filtration has helped. And what I did was put some extra live rock in with the fish and a snail, which I don't think you can see at the moment, but he's in there, to try and reduce the ammonia. And I've changed the water frequently, and in this bucket I've hardly changed the water at all. It's just got a circulation pump going around to circulate the water over the live rock, and the ammonia in this bucket is now down to almost zero, so that's good, because the live rock hasn't died. And what I'm going to do in a minute is just siphon the old water out of here into this empty bucket and put some of this water into here, so that the fish produces the ammonia and then the live rock eats it, so that the live rock doesn't starve and the fish doesn't get poisoned. The species, I think I've correctly identified them now. Let's try and get them into view for you, but the fish is hiding. Anyway, it's as far as I know, it's a gold banded maroon clamfish, and the snail is Astrea, I don't know how you pronounce it, conehead snail. And in here there's three, at least three crabs, and none of them are visible at the moment, I think. But, well, the little one there. They are, as far as I know, electric blue hermit crabs. You can see pictures of them on Facebook. Just go to the Octopus Project on Facebook and you'll find them. Now, over to the tank. This is a 180 litre tank. Check the substrate today. You can see it here. I wasn't sure if this was going to be too coarse for an octopus and hurt its skin, but it doesn't have any sharp edges, so should be okay. But I'm actually managed to find a very good deal on a bigger tank, whole glass tank with a stand. So as I said, this is 180 litres. The new one's going to be 343, so just about twice the size. And so I'm getting that on Saturday in 5 days, and I shall get some additional substrate, and we can eventually start getting these guys out of there and hopefully into better health. So that is the story for now. You can follow the blog on youtube.com/djkaty and the number 1. And I will report back soon. Bye.